Hello YouTubers. I thought I'd quickly throw in this quick video snippet again on the troubleshooting of the Amazon Kindle. It's now the last update was taken yesterday afternoon when I showed you that it had managed to charge. I'd left it on overnight because what I'm to see, was keen to see whether if I left it on whether it would still end up discharging itself again. And I just wanted to demonstrate. What I did was I've connected up this Fluke multimeter now to measure the voltage. Because what I've realized is I kind of need to incorporate a transistor of sorts which actually only allows the current to switch on once there's enough voltage and current to actually charge properly. As you can see, what's happening is it's early morning, there's no direct sunlight coming in, the panel's in the window. So although the panel gets a fair amount of voltage, no real current. So as you can see, what it ends up doing, it ends up pulsing up and down. If you look at the bar graph on the Fluke, it just sits there pulsing. And what that, and as you can see what happens, the charge light flicks on and off. And then if we open the Kindle and I switch it on, you'll remember again yesterday, it managed to get up to about a third of its charge. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually unplug, you can actually, if you note the little lightning bolt goes on and off, I'm going to unplug the power and you'll see that it's almost dropped down to nothing. So it's slowly discharging itself basically by, I think, activating and deactivating the internal charge circuit of the Amazon Kindle. So the interesting thing is that when you pull out the power, the capacitor sits and builds up its the capacitor and sitting inside that heat shrink with the voltage regulator sits and it builds up the voltage. I'll actually just demonstrate that. This is something I demonstrated on the oscilloscope program. So if I put it in, it obviously quickly discharges, but there's not enough current to maintain a good charge. Now I pull it out. And you'll see the capacitor slowly, well, fairly quickly builds up a charge. That's why I'm hoping to use a combination of supercapacitors and a transistor that'll actually resolve this issue. But there you go. Thanks again for watching and do subscribe if you enjoy these videos.